chapter of strings, and we have already covered so many practicals of default function of strings and the other three practicals, but now these are the last two practicals. So the first practical, as you can see, is saying me that write a program which accepts a long string and print only character at positions which are multiple of 3. So what exactly this program is saying me? So if I open my whiteboard, you can see that here, suppose I am having one string, say Komal, right, and last is null character. So here what it is saying me that the position should be multiple of 3. So I am considering the index level over here, or you can also think it as a position of character. So let us think it as position of character. So it is index is I's value is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now I am going to print only if it is divisible by 3. Divisible by 3. Right. So I want to print the character only if its position is divisible by or index is divisible by 3. So what values are this? These are the values of I. So if I is divisible by 3, then only I am going to print the element at that index. So how can I perform that program? So for that I am writing include stdio.h, then int main, here it will be return 0, here it will be char s1 100, S2, 100, right? So I am taking two strings, or I just need one string. So this one is extra. Now I need int I because I is the index of loop. Now what I am going to do? I am going from first character or first index. Till how much length I'm going? I'm going from 0th index to the length of string. I'm going from 0th index to the length of string. So you have two options over here. Either find length and run the loop from 0 to length minus 1, right? So first option is this. Second option is check if a of I is not equal to null. So you are going to run this loop until you are not getting a of I as null. So I can write anything, but I am it is convenient for me to use the condition of null character. So I'm checking if a of I is not equal to null, then go further. Then last but not the least, I'm doing I plus plus, right? So inside this for loop, what I'm going to do here, if I modulo 3 equal to 0, that is if the index is divisible by 3, then only I'm going to print percentage C S1 of I. So when will this print the S1 of I? Only when the position is divisible by 3. So let me just save this program, compile it. What is an error? A is not declared. So here it is S1 of I, right? So correct it, save it, compile it and run it again. Now it is not asking me for any string because I have not written any function to take string from user. So therefore for that I have to write printf enter a string, and here I am writing getS. I am using getS function. So instead of getS I am writing S1. So whatever string will be entered by user will be stored to S1. Now let me save this program, compile it and run it. If I am entering formal, it is just printing from the index 0, that is K, and 1, 2 and 3rd index, that is A. It is printing ka, right? So this is how I can perform this practical. Now let me execute it again and show you for some other strings. I have very busy day today. So in this entire string, it is just printing the statements, right? So this is how you can perform this practical, in which you are just printing the characters at position which is divisible by 3. So let me just erase it, right? Now last but not the least, write a C program to accept a string and print every third character from string only if it is lowercase. So first I am going to check this condition. But I am not blindly printing it. If this condition is true, as well as if s1 of I is lowercase, that is of smaller alphabets, then only I am going to print it. So if it is containing some capital letters, then I am not going to print it. So how we change the logic? We can use ASCII value for that. Because if the range is something like this, you can also use AND condition, and you can write S1 of I is greater than or equal to character A, and S1 of I is less than or equal to Z, then only print. Now let me check this. Save this program, compile it and run it. I am entering K as capital because it's 0th index and other letters are small. It is just printing A because K is capital. So it does not fall in the range of this range. And we have used AND condition. AND condition means this 3 conditions should be true to execute this statement, right? So if I am entering, you know, some other value, today is very busy day for me. So it is just printing these random numbers. So this is all about this practical. Now sometimes it may happen that you don't know what is the ASCII value of some particular character, because here it is okay, you can compare characters. But what if you don't know the ASCII value? At that time you can use, let me erase everything. At that time you can use, say, int x, one integer character, integer and one character, right? I just want to take character from user, so I am taking percentage C, and here it will be go inside C, and here I am printing printf. Percentage D C. So I don't need actually. I don't need X. So I am printing, and here it will be AND. Okay. So now let me just save this, compile it, and running it. If I am entering small a, it is printing 97. So suppose if you don't know what is the ASCII value, you can find it in this way in some practical exams if you want. Now the homework program, or you know how you can use these ASCII values to toggle the statement. So the next program, the extra program, is how to toggle the string. Now what is the meaning of toggling the string? So toggling the string, that means suppose user have entered KO, MA, L and Langaria, my surname. So the answer should be small KOMA and capital KOML, LANGALI. I want to toggle the characters, that if the character is in uppercase, you have to convert it to lowercase, and if it is in lowercase, you have to convert it to uppercase. So how you can perform the program? And for that you must know the ASCII values. So for capital A, small a, it is 97 that I have just checked. Now let me check for other characters. So for small z it is 1, 2, 2. So for small z it is 1, 2, 2. Now for capital A and capital Z, let me check it again. So for capital A it is 65. So it is 65. And for capital Z it will be 90. Now what is the difference between capital A and small a? So if I minus them, then I know that 97 capital A minus small a, that is 97 minus 65, so the answer is 32. You can see that here also small z minus capital Z is equal to 32. So I know that for any alphabet difference between small letter and capital letter will be 32. So what can I do to toggle a string? Now let me just perform that program in which I am toggling the string. So for that, first I have to take character array str1 or str string that need to be toggled having size 100. Then I need to printf enter the string, right? Here scanf, inside scanf I'm right entering percent, or I can use get as also. So get as str, I am taking this string, right? So user will be able to enter the string. Now after that I'm checking for I equal to 0, str of I not equal to null, up to last character I'm checking, then do I plus plus, and here what I can do, if a of I str of I is greater than or equal to 97, right? So if it is greater than or equal to, first I'm just toggling to I'm showing you the program to convert entire string into lower string. Now you can write your own logic to toggle the string. So I'm not giving you the entire program, I'm just giving you hint for that, right? Because this is an extra practical that I'm going to show you. So what I'm going to do, whatever the uppercase letters are, I'm going to whatever the smaller case letters are, I'm going to convert it to uppercase. How can I convert this? So how can I detect that the alphabet is in lowercase? I can detect if it is falling in between the range of 97 and str of I is less than or equal to 1, 2, 2. That means the character is smaller case. Then what we are going to do? Str of I equal to str of I plus, sorry, minus 32. I am just minus the difference. So now its ASCII value will be minus 32. So it will be converted to uppercase, and at the end I'm going to put as say str. Right. Here let me write printf slash n. Let me just save this program and check if we have done correct logic, or we have implemented correct logic or not. I is not declared, int I. Now if I'm entering KOMALLANGLIA, comma lagaya, you can see it is converting to entire string into uppercase. Now you can think about this program and try to implement the logic where you can toggle. If the character is in uppercase, you have to toggle it to lowercase. And if it is in lowercase, you have to toggle it to uppercase. I hope you enjoyed this class and have some knowledge about strings. If you have any doubt, you can comment below the comment section and ask me. See you in the next class. Thank you so much.